A locomotive engine pulls two cars. So this is car one and this is car two. Car one is M, car two is 2M. Calculate the forces that the links experience, TA and TB, as the train accelerates to the right. Let's do free body analysis of the cars. So first consider this 2A, 2M. 2M is pulled by a force named TB. Okay. The first car is M, pulled by a force called TA forward, at the same time a force called TB backward. Now we write the Newton's second law for each case. For this, Newton's second law is going to be F net MA. For F net in this case, it's TB. M is 2M. And the acceleration is the acceleration of the system, which is A. For the second case, which is car 1, TA force is forward, TB force is backward. So therefore, net force is F net. This is what we are going to write again, M times A. So for F net here is TA minus TB, because the whole system is moving to the right. So that means TA is positive, TB is negative. The difference is F net. Okay, so F net part is this, equal. M is M, for this case is M. Acceleration, again, acceleration of the system. To compare TA and TB, or to calculate the forces that the links experience as the train accelerates to the right, to do that, okay, so we take this first. TA is TA, TB is 2M times A, so that means I can safely write 2MA instead of TB, equal M times A. After rearranging, TA MA plus 2MA, so that means TA is 3MA. So now we know that TB is already 2 times MA, TA is 3 times MA, so that means this is 2 times, this is 3 times big. So we can compare like that, because we don't have numerical values for acceleration and the mass. Another way of finding TA is considering these two cars as one single body. How? So we can think that 2M and M are united. There is no link, TA link. This whole thing is now pulled forward by a force called TA. So we can see that it's already, TA is already pulling not only M, but also pulling 2M as well. So with that, we can also write like that. So for this, our Newton's second law, F net MA equation, TA is F net, 2M plus M is the mass and the acceleration of the system. So this gives us 3MA, same as above. And that agrees with the above result. That's it. So if we, let's say, numerical values are given, let's say M is 100 kilogram, acceleration, let's say, 2 meters per second. If so, the TA now is 3 times of M times A. So TA comes 3MA, so that gives us 3 times 2 times 100, 600 kilogram meter per second. Second square, because acceleration is meter per second square. So TB is 2 times MA, so that gives us 2 times 100, so that is 400 kilogram meter per second square. Kilogram meter per second square is also Newton. We could directly write 600 Newton and 400 Newton.